Hi, I'm Bob with LPS Computer. We're going to talk about the error code 22:10 on a Designjet 800 and 500. They're the same error code and the same fix. The error code indicates that the printer doesn't like what it's seeing with the ink supply station. Ink supply station is on the right side of the machine, and it's where the ink is normally kept, and it matches up the ink cartridges with the ink tube assembly, which provides ink to the carriage and the print heads and so on. The second function of a ink supply station, also called an ISS, is that there's a chip in here that's actually a read-only memory, and the printer ID, the serial number, the model number, and all of the settings are backed up onto this. Now, when the printer's turned on, the electronics on this side goes out to say hello to it and make sure all of that matches up. And if it doesn't match up, it's going to ask you on the front panel what has changed. So we're going to get into that a little later after we actually make the change, and I'll show you how to make the correct selection. Making the wrong selection is really not a good thing. The printer won't work. There are two types of ink supply stations for the 500-800. I'm holding the newer one in my hand. The older style is like this, and it uses a large plastic bracket that mounts on the back of the frame, and then this clips into it. They are absolutely interchangeable. The connectors are exactly the same. The main difference is their appearance. The newer type mounts where the old bracket mounts, so that would have to come off. And they fit exactly the same, even though they're physically quite different in appearance. To replace these, we need to first get the ink out of the machine. So we'll do that. And then this end cover needs to come off. The cover's got five screws on it. I'll show you where they are. There's one in the front, down at the bottom, right here. These are all T15s, by the way. There's one on the inside. We have to open the cover to get to it. That's this one right here. One on top, right here. And there are two in the back. Now I'm going to swing the machine around because it's going to be easier to see everything from the back from here on. Okay, the last two screws are this one here in this corner. And one in the bottom corner. And after this one's out, the cover just slips off. Okay, the ink supply station has two bundles of wires coming up. The blue bundle, and then there's another bundle that's red, black, and green. We'll pull those off the interconnect board. We need to take the ink tube system off too. This is the ink tube system coming in. These are the ports for the ink cartridges. Now there are two latches here and here. You simply squeeze those together and lift this out. That's all there is to that. This is mounted by a single screw. They're generally painted red, like this one is. It's a T10. And we'll remove that. Now this is going to be pulled to the side just a little bit and it comes out. That's all there is to it. Putting another one in, we're going to put one in so that it changes the ID of the printer or confuses the printer, then we're going to straighten it out. Putting it in is just the opposite procedure. Set it in there and just move it to the right. Now you see it's already in and lined up. We'll just put the screw back in. You don't want to get this too tight because you'll smash the plastic and break it. So just get it snugged up. It's good enough. It's not going anywhere. And we'll plug these back into the interconnect board. Just like that. Now some people have had difficulty putting this back in, but it's really not difficult. There's a tab right here on the end that goes into a slot down here. So if you get that tab in there first, into the slot, and just rotate it down, all you have to do is line up these holes with these little posts here, and it snaps in, and that's it. That's it. That's about all there is to that replacement. So let's put the ink back in and power it up. I'll show you how the machine's going to respond to having a different ink supply station in there. So let me rotate this around again. Okay, we're ready to power this back up. And as you will see, it doesn't boot normally. It's going to come up and ask us a question, like what's been changed? And we have to answer that question correctly, and then the machine will boot and go ahead and start working. Okay. It says an EEROM discrepancy. That's because the information in the electronics module does not match the backup information. So to get the backup information to match, we have to answer this question correctly. Was the main board replaced, which is inside the electronics module? No. Was the ink supply station replaced? Yes. Both replaced? No. Neither replaced. So we're going to choose ink supply station replaced and hit enter. Now the machine will back up the all of its information and settings to the new ink supply station we just put in and continue to boot and live happily ever after. This will come up and ask for paper here in just a minute. There it is. Okay, I'm going to power it down again, and I left the end cover off for a reason. And that is, I'm going to put the old style ink supply station in here just to demonstrate how that is done. It's actually done exactly the same way. However, there are many doubting Thomases out there. And I've been challenged 100 times on this that they are not the same because they look different. But you should never judge an ink supply station by its cover. So we'll take this off. And this goes on exactly the same. Whoops. Well, you will see this goes on the same way. Same screw, same hole, same mounting. And you can see the connectors fit, everything fits. If you're in question about which of these to order from our website, take the end cover off and take a look. That's one way to know for sure. The other way is that the old style, you can see, is black across the top, plain plastic, and the new style has steel strips across the top. So even without taking the covers off, you should be able to see either steel or this. That'll tell you old style, new style. We've got plenty of these in stock, so to order them, all you really need to do is go to our website at www.lpscomputer.com and browse to the Designjet 500-800s parts page, and you can see them there side by side. Choose whichever you want, put in the shopping cart, and check out. Shipping be done however you want it done. You just choose that in the checkout. Or you can call us at 800-959-1575 and you can talk to one of our very pleasant ladies taking orders. And they'll be glad to help you out. And that's about it for the ink supply station on the 500-800. It's a very easy repair. It's kind of a problematic area. Anyway, I'll see you next time. Thank you.